So based on the observations from his monohybrid crows, he formulated two important laws. So before going to the laws, what was his observations? He observed that when he took a pair of contrasting character, that is a pair of characters in their parents, in the F1, only one character was shown. The other character remained hidden. That character that was appearing in the F1, he called as a dominant character. And that which appeared only in the F2 generation, he called as a recessive character. In this case, when he crossed a tall plant with a dwarf plant, in F1, all plants were tall. That means that the tallness is a dominant character. And the recessive character, or that is, a dwarf is a recessive character, it was not shown in the F1 generation. So always F1 generation shows the dominant character. But when the F1 plants are self-pollinated, in the F2, the recessive character will appear again. But it appears only less in number. And that character is called as the recessive character according to Mendel. He also observed that this character from the parents reaches the young ones through discrete stable units. At that time, microscopy was not there. About nucleus, chromosome, genes, nobody has studied. But still, he told that there are certain discrete unit or stable units which are passed from parents to offspring, which can transmit the characters from parents to offspring. And he named it as factors. So, now the factors are known as genes, but Bentel called it as factors. So, according to him, factors are stable, discrete units which are passed from parents to offspring that bring about character in them. Now, based on his monohybrid crows, he formulated two laws. The first law of Mendel is called as law of dominance. This law states that when we consider a pair of contrasting character, only one character will appear in the F1 and that is the dominant character. The other character will appear only in the F2 generation. This also states that in F1 only the dominant character will be shown and only in the F2 the recessive character will be appearing. Then Mendel also told that there is no blending of genes. What's the meaning of blending? Blending means mixing. Why he told that there is no blending of genes? The reason was that he could get only tall and dwarf plants in the offspring. There was no plant with an intermediate height. So he came to the conclusion that there is no blending of genes or mixing of genes. So these are the things he formulated in his first law, that is law of dominance. So when two parents with contrasting characters are crossed, in the F1 only one character will be shown, that is the dominant character. The character which appears in the F2 is the recessive character. It remains hidden in the F1 generation. Now coming to the second law. The second law of Mendel is known as the universally accepted law of Mendel. The reason is that the other laws of Mendel shows deviations that we will study later in this chapter. So, second law is called as law of segregation. It is also called law of purity of gametes. Now, what does it state? It states that an organism may not be pure for a character. We will take the example of this tall plant. This tall plant appears as a tall plant, but actually it is not pure for the character because it is having a gene for dwarfness also. And this plant, when it produces gametes, what happens? 50% of the gametes will have capital T as the gene in it. And the 50% will be having small t in it. That is, the gametes will have only one of the genes of the allelic pair. Ippa naal allelic pair nammal orumichu consider cheyanengil oro gametesilum ee naal allelic pair indeyum oronorone kaanathu. Adha or allelic pair orumichu orikkal or gametil povilla. Allelic pair la orenam vide povan pattathu. So that means that the gametes are always pure for the character. If we consider this gamete, it is pure for the character tall. If we consider this gamete, it is pure for the character dwarf. That is, the gametes are always pure for the character. That's why we call this law as law of purity of gametes. This law is also called the law of segregation because the gametes, when gametes are formed that time, the allelic pair will separate independently and each of the gamete will have only one of the genes of the allelic pair. That's why it is called the law of segregation.